I'm Melissa from the Volusia County Public Library. Thank you for joining me today. We're going to be making some wire and bead pendants that you can put on a chain or a rope to wear around your neck as a necklace. They're pretty easy to make. You really just need 3 beads, some wire, and some needle nose pliers. So you can see that I've got some wire here. I've got lots of different beads to choose from, and you can use any kind of beads that you'd like. I think the round ones work a little bit better for this project. So I've picked some colors that I think will go good with the gold wire. And the last one that I made, I used this pink wire. It kind of looks almost like a rose gold. So the first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and string our 3 beads in whichever order you want them in, right onto our wire. I'm using 16 gauge wire, and this one is pretty flexible too. The wires that are thicker, that are a little tougher to bend, might not work so well with this project. So I've got my 3 beads on there in the order that I want them. And we're just going to go ahead and bend the end of the wire so that it's rounded, so we can put it onto a chain or a rope and make it into a necklace. And then we're going to start bending our wire up toward our loop, and then go ahead and bend it around the loop and then back down on the other side, like so. And that is essentially what we're going to keep doing. We're going to bend it underneath the bottom bead and then back up around the side, bend it around the top, or twist it, and then come back around to the bottom. And don't worry about the bottom. I know that wires won't be connected yet. I'm gonna cut some of my wire off so it's a little easier to work with. And then I'm gonna take the end of my wire and just kind of thread it through the bottom part of our pendant so that we can wrap all of those wires together. And every time I go around the top, I wind it around our loop. And then you just repeat that process. And once you've gone around a few times, you'll see that it all kind of sits together and it's very sturdy. And remember that you can control how much wire you use. If you only want a few loops going around the beads, that's all up to you. I've got a few going around and I think I am about done, so I'm just going to wrap my wire around there a couple of times and then cut it around the top loop. And then I'm going to use my pliers to push that end of the wire down into itself so it doesn't stick out. And then I'm just going to straighten it and straighten my beads out, and that is my wire pendant. It's very unique and would make a great gift. There are books in our library that are available for checkout. These are a couple of good ones here. Designing bead and wire jewelry, everything the beginner needs to know. And the other one is beaded jewelry, wire work techniques. These are both available here at the Volusia County Public Library for checkout. Thank you so much again for joining me today.